What's up, everybody? All right, so I got a lot of questions about modes and music theory. With theory, I love teaching it. It's gonna take me a little while to figure out the starting point and bridging out from there. I'm gonna do a huge tutorial on that. I wanna get into modes and modal playing. So what I really wanted to make sure that you guys understand are your modes and your major scales and the numerics. If I say a 4, a flat 3, you guys know what that is. And let's just go ahead and get started. So it's a little bit more advanced, a little bit more theory-based for some of you heavier players. What really tricks people is if we have a jam, right? If, kind of a 2-5-1 here, so A minor 7, D7 to G major 7, right? Typical Dorian, A Dorian. The only reason that that can get you stuck is you're literally thinking about the Dorian mode kind of boxing in, right? And for a lot of players, if we were to kind of sit down and kind of be in a jam session, right? Now I'm not in Dorian technically anymore. Right, I'm all the way up here, right? I guess you could almost say like I started in Mixolydian because I'm starting on this position. I'm in like my D, right? Kind of outlining that A minor there. And there's a reason that that becomes more beneficial than just learning the boxed modes. Learning the boxed modes can be great, but more learning the notes, which I'm gonna get into later. That'll be the second part of this. The first part is just going to be an exercise. And I love this exercise. This helps so much. We're just gonna take, let's just say we're gonna stick in A minor, all right? What you're gonna do is you're gonna find all your A's that you can. All right, and then kind of jump up to your next octave. Once that becomes comfortable, we're in our A minor, you're gonna add the flat three, or I'm sorry, the minor third. Now, even in that minor third, a few of them are gonna have two. Right, that's my A, my minor third, that's my minor third there. Okay, same here. Minor third. What this is going to do is gonna start carving out from those notes where the next notes in the scale lie. Okay, so then you add your flat seven. Now we have. Now here, but we also have this. Same with here. Right, so you're just making sure that you're finding all of those notes. And then so on, adding the fourth in. Or even if we just did one flat three, minor third. I keep saying flat three, but it's really minor third. One minor third, 4 to 5, right? Take all of those for each one of the A's. All the way up as many as you can find. All right, now it's starting to become a little bit easier to navigate. And what you can start doing is then putting together. So if you have 1 minor third 4 to 5, but you've already done the exercise where you're doing the 1 to the flat 7, now you can bridge them all together. What I mean by that is, you know, this is an A, that's an A, and that's an A. So you know you can do 1 flat 3 4 5. You know if that's your A right here, that's your flat 7, which is your next note in the scale, and you're just gonna go right up that scale. Now, that obviously is gonna be a little bit easier because that's our normal pentatonic position, but that's the idea. All up and down the neck, you're kind of finding all of the A's and then bridging the rest of the notes together. All right, so then there's really nothing stopping you. The other reason that I want you guys to focus on that, and that is really important too, is if you're like just playing a blues, if you're gonna do, right, very typical blues lick. If I jump into here, if I do, right, so I'm up here the original lick is down here in this pentatonic. I got my 7, so kind of like, right, 7 bent, 7 normal, 5, and then ending on my A. Now, if I were to take that, say I learned, you know, if I was up here in my 12th position and I was kind of going through my pentatonic modes, the pentatonic modes, if I was up here, I might not play that. I might do, because in that pentatonic form, that's where it looks and feels the most normal, because that's what you did down here. But that's not going to be the same. Now, the notes might line up a little bit, so it might not sound super dissonant, but it's not going to be the same as, right, that lick right there. So now you're able to put that together, so you're not just thinking like, all right, wait, here are my notes, you know, in this mode of the pentatonic, or then once we get into to full modes, these are my modes and this is how I'm playing it. You're focusing more on those notes that you actually want to play rather than just, you know, running the scales up and down. So the reason that first exercise becomes so important is the only thing that's really changing. So when we have our minor pentatonics, we have our one, minor third, four, five, and flat seven, right? Five notes. There's only two notes missing now. All right, we have our two and our six. All right, so in a Dorian, it's a natural two and a natural six, right? That's our scale. So it's a minor pentatonic with a natural two and a natural six. So you just start adding those in, which is that original example that I gave you. When I jumped up, I did not play Dorian here. Right, that's my A, and I know that that's my two and my flat three. Right, jumped up, that's my five, so that's my six. Flat seven, back to my natural six. That's how you start thinking in those ways. Now, from that point, let's just take one more example. If I were to do, stay in A minor, we're gonna do another A minor seven. Let's see, if I were to do A minor seven to B flat major seven. Right, just to kind of give you something in Phrygian. So what that is your minor pentatonic. Now we have a flat two and a flat six, right? So that becomes our scale. So now, anywhere you are, if I'm thinking about that, sorry about that buzz. Right, and no point am I thinking like, all right, well, I'm in D and I'm trying to play around it. It just becomes knowing that minor pentatonic and adding the two and the six in. It becomes very, very easy to start building that in. Now, I wanna get into a little bit of theory about why the two and the six are so important. The major note changes, really revolve around the other chords that are being played. And what I mean by that is if I just play an A minor seven, there's nothing in there that's giving me any two or any six, which means the pentatonic will sound fine. If you start adding different twos and different sixes in, you're gonna start gravitating towards that certain key, that certain scale, but there's nothing in the rhythm that is giving that to you. So if I take a very easy example, A minor seven to D minor seven, that gives me my six. Now, bear with me. My A minor seven chord is my one, my minor third, my five, and my flat seven, right? So in the pentatonic scale, the only thing that's not there is a four, but a four is a very neutral note, so it's implied almost all the time, right? So you never really have to worry about that four being a sharp four. So when I go to my D minor seven now, there's my four, neutral note, so really not that big of a deal. But I have my four, here's my six, my four, my flat six, my one, but then my minor third again. So that's where the six really comes in, the flat six. Now the reason that becomes so significant, and the reason that I wanted to get more musical with this, is now you can start accentuating those notes by playing the four, the flat six, the one, and the flat three mostly the 4 and the flat 6 when you get to that chord. Does that make sense? I'm going to stop right there and go to part 2.